Hi everyone, welcome to Paradise Move of the Week. We are in week number one for the month of November. Now, for today, we're going to do a little bit of a scary move. I know when I teach this move in the studio, you know, the students do get a bit hesitant, they're a bit nervous. Yes, I will admit the first time you try it, it is rather scary. But the more you do this, then obviously you're going to get a lot better at it. Now, this move, unfortunately, is called the suicide leg. Yes, I know, crazy name, huh? Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to demonstrate the move to you first, and then I'll explain what we're going to do. And that is the suicide leg. So now let me explain while I'm already up here on the hoop. So once you get into your hoop, whichever mount you like to do is fine, we're then going to go into a top knee hang. So remember, you're going to lift your legs up, engage your core, keep the arms engaged as well, and hook the knees onto the hoop. Now what I like to do, you can do this in an overhand or an underhand grip. I like to do this in an underhand grip, so I switch my hands around in an underhand grip on the outside of the hook. I tuck my knees in towards my face, tucking myself into a very nice little ball, and with control, I slowly roll over to land on my knees, or just underneath my knees. Then from there, I'm slowly going to press each foot onto the hoop and extend both of my legs. My arms and my legs are extended. Keeping my core engaged, I'm going to lift one leg up. That leg is going to go on the outside of the hoop, and I'm just going to start to split outwards. Keeping my core engaged so I don't sway from side to side. Now, once I'm ready to come back in, I bend that leg back in, placing it back onto the bottom of the hoop. I'm going to use my arms to pull me into the hoop, and I'm going to take one hand, re-grip the hoop on the outside or the back of the hoop. I'm going to sit down into the opposite side of the hoop from the hand that I just used to grip the hoop. Then once I'm sitting down, I can then release my feet, and I will then finish in a normal sitting position. So just try to be safe, of course, when you're doing these moves at home or in whichever studio you're practicing. And I hope you enjoyed that, everyone. And we will see you again next week.